Now back to the potential sources of error. The fact that the Earth is a sphere. Well, we decided that's not 100% true, but the Earth is so close to spherical that any error it introduces is negligible. We also decide that the Sun's rays don't arrive exactly in parallel, though you're going to do more about this in the homework. But the error this introduces turns out to be negligible. Let's talk about point three. Do the Sun's rays actually arrive vertically in Syene? Now, to answer this question, let's think back to how Eratosthenes came to this conclusion. Eratosthenes had come to this conclusion by hearing that if you look down a well, not necessarily a poorly drawn well, but a well, in Syene, on the summer solstice, you could see the very bottom. What this meant was that the sun's rays must have been striking in such a way that a ray which entered the top of the well could make it all the way to the bottom. And so his conclusion was that the sun's rays are striking vertically. Now let's see if this is necessarily the case. Sure, a ray that comes in vertically will make it all the way to the bottom of the well, no problem. But is that the only ray that will go from top of the well to the bottom? No. What about this one? This ray also illuminates the bottom of the well, and it comes in at a slight angle. Now, let's look at what the maximum possible angle could be that would allow one of these rays to enter the top of the well and still illuminate the ground below. And that would be this ray. If we tried to make this angle any steeper, it wouldn't actually hit the bottom of the well, it would hit somewhere along the wall. So how can we calculate this angle? Well, let's make some assumptions about the depth of the well and the width of the well that Eratosthenes was looking at. Now, I'm no well expert, but I'm going to assume that this well had a depth of 40 meters. Those of you who know more about wells than I do can tell me if this is a reasonable depth for a well. I'm going to assume that the width of the well, so from this edge to this edge, was about 1 meter. Now, we have the dimensions of our well. We have an extreme case solar ray coming down and just barely illuminating the bottom of the well. Now, I wonder, what angle does this correspond to? We know it's not quite vertical. Using your new trig skills, I bet you can tell me what this angle alpha is that this ray is making with the vertical. Enter your answer in this box, rounded to 2 decimal places. And remember, Google is your friend.